Today we will discuss buffer solution in ionic equilibrium. First of all, we will discuss about this buffer. What is buffer? It is a solution which can resist changes in pH even when you are adding acid or base. So when we are adding acid or base, it can resist changes in its pH. It doesn't show any changes in the pH. That kind of solution is called as buffer solution. Even this buffer action plays a key role in our blood itself. Clear? Now, what is buffer? Generally, there are two kinds of buffer solution. First, it is weak acid and its conjugate base. Second is weak base and its conjugate acid. First of all, you should know what is weak acid. What is meant by weak acid? Already in 10th itself you studied. The acid which will dissociate partially is called as weak acid. Best example is acetic acid. So acetic acid and sodium acetate is an example for weak acid and its conjugate base. Same manner, for weak base, we can say ammonium hydroxide as a best example. Ammonium hydroxide and ammonium chloride. That is the example for this weak base and its conjugate acid. Now, let us discuss the types of buffer solution. Acid buffer solution, basic buffer solution. First, buffer action in acid. Here, we are taking weak acid and its conjugate base. Weak acid, I said, it will dissociate partially. That's why here reversible sign is there. So, on dissociation of acetic acid, it gives H plus plus CH3COO minus. So, reversible sign is there as it is partially ionized. Next, sodium ion is there. So, it will ionize completely. Sodium acetate is dissociated to sodium and acetate ion. Now, I am going to explain how this buffer action takes place in this acid buffer. We are adding base here. Suppose when we are adding base, at that time it will react with this H plus so that it forms water. Thus, it is nullifying the effect of base. Same manner, when we are adding acid to this buffer solution, at that time acid H plus, so that will react with acetate ion so that it forms weak acid. So acid concentration, it is nullifying. Likewise, it is balancing on the addition of both base as well as acid. Next most important topic is common ion effect. Common ion effect means the dissociation of a weak acid or base also. Either dissociation of a weak acid or base, it is suppressed by the addition of its own ion. For example, here I am taking acetic acid. Acetic acid on dissociation produces acetate and H+. After that, I am adding sodium acetate. At that time, the sodium acetate, it is dissociated to acetate and sodium ion. Here, acetate ion is there. Same manner, here also acetate ion is there. So, due to this addition of sodium acetate, the dissociation of weak acid is suppressed. So, it doesn't dissociate further. Due to the addition of common ion, the dissociation is suppressed. That effect is called as common ion effect. Based on this common ion effect only, now we are going to derive the Henderson-Eisenberg equation. Clear, students? Now, we are going to derive Henderson-Eisenberg equation for the weak acid. Weak acid, it is dissociated to acetate and H plus ion, already we discussed. In 11th standard itself, you know What is meant by equilibrium constant? Equilibrium constant, what we said? It is defined as the ratio of concentration, molar concentration of the products to the molar concentration of the reactants. Already you studied in 11th standard, no? Just recall that. Here, why I am writing Ka in the sense, dissociation constant of acid is equal to, generally we are writing product. Product on the numerator side and reactant in the denominator side. So, CH3COO minus, the square bracket is must because it is molar concentration. So, CH3COO minus into H plus by CH3COOH. Now, we are going to find out the Anderson-Heisenberg equation for the weak acid. So, we are taking H plus ion alone. So, cross multiply it. H plus is equal to Ka into CH3COOH by CH3COO minus CH3COOH acid. CH3COO minus, we are saying, no, that it is taken as salt. One more important thing here, acetic acid is taken as the original concentration of acid. Same manner, this CH3COO minus salt, it is taken as the original concentration of salt. Already in last equation I said, no, here as it is weak acid, already its dissociation is less. Further, we are adding sodium acetate also. So, due to common ion effect, again dissociation is further suppressed. That is why we are taking this acetic acid as the original concentration of acid, and this acetate ion is taken as the original concentration of salt. Because here itself dissociation is less, so obviously product formation also it is less. That's why we are taking it as original concentration. Now what I am doing is, we are taking log on both the sides. So log H plus is equal to log Ka. Whenever we are using this word logarithm, multiplication means it should come as addition. So plus log acid by salt. Now what I am doing in the sense, I am reversing the sign on both the sides. So on reversing, what happened? This log H plus becomes minus log H plus is equal to minus log Ka, here minus log of acid by salt. Already you know minus log H plus, what is minus log H plus? pH. So pH is defined as the negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration, already we know very well. That is why minus log H plus becomes pH, minus log Ka becomes pKa. Here I am changing the sign. So whenever we are changing the sign, this salt, it comes in the numerator side and acid comes in the denominator side. So plus log of acid by salt by acid. So what is the final Henderson equation? pH is equal to pKa plus log of salt by acid. So now we got the Anderson-Heisenberg equation for the weak acid. Likewise, if you are doing it for weak base, we will get this. POH is equal to pKb plus log of salt by base. So in today's class, what we discussed? What is meant by buffer? And what are the types of buffer solution? Next thing is, what is common ion effect? Finally, what we discussed? By using the common ion effect, we derive the Anderson-Heisenberg equation for weak acid as well as weak base. With this, we'll complete this today's class, students. We'll discuss the rest of the topics in the next class.